In this video, we will see the working of the hydraulic brake system. So here I have written the topic name. It is actually the layout of hydraulic brake system. In layout, I would be describing how the hydraulic brake system is constructed. That is how it looks like. So if we can see here in this diagram which I have, here we have 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are 4 wheels, and as we can see, in one wheel we are having one internal expanding brake. Next, in the second wheel also, third and fourth wheel. In all the wheels we are having internal expanding brake, also called as drum brake. Next, as we can see here, the piston and cylinder arrangement which is provided in each of the internal expanding brake, that is connected to a master cylinder. So if we are looking into the construction part of hydraulic braking system, hydraulic brake system consists of master cylinder, inside which we have piston and spring. Then this master cylinder would be actuated with the help of brake pedal here. Brake pedal will be moved about this pivot. That is, pivot is a fixed point about which the brake pedal will move. Then after that we have 4 internal expanding brakes. There is wheel cylinder. After that, through the master cylinder, there are pipelines which are going into each of the internal expanding brake. Then here we have brake drum and brake shoes for the internal expanding brake. So this was in brief the construction of hydraulic braking system. Now how it works? The working depends on the brake pedal. Here we are having a brake pedal. If we are applying the force on this brake pedal, by applying the force means when we are pressing the brake pedal with the help of the foot lever, in that case, when it is pressed, here we are having a piston. Master cylinder would be filled with brake fluid, also called as brake oil. So since the medium is hydraulic, hydraulic means it uses oil, and that oil is nothing but brake oil. So when we are pressing the brake pedal through the linkage, that is the pivot, the brake pedal, it will move the piston in the forward direction. When the piston moves in the forward direction, it will be compressing the brake oil which is filled in the master cylinder. So the pressure of the oil rises. Now that high pressure oil will go into the channels which are provided. It will go into the 2 front wheels. It will go into the 2 rear wheels. Once the hydraulic oil passes in one of the wheel, it will be pushing these pistons. These small pistons are there. So the brake oil will exert the force on each of the piston, and when the force is exerted on the piston, here we would be having pivots, and about the pivot, this brake shoe would be moving outward, and when it moves outward, it would be coming in contact with the rotating brake drum, and hence the braking action takes place. So similarly it will happen in each of the wheels. Just by pressing one brake pedal, we are able to actuate the brake in 4 of the wheels. That is, the vehicle would be stopped. It would be stopped just by pressing the brake pedal, and it is very much understood that when the brake pedal would be pressed, oil passes through each of the cylinders simultaneously, and all the wheels, they would be stopping at once. It is not as such that oil will go into the first cylinder, it would be stopping first, then second, third, fourth. No, when the oil would be coming, it would be passing through all the cylinders at the same time, and then we are getting the braking action. So this was regarding the hydraulic brake system.